Hello everybody, this is Wilson Developer back with another video. In this video, we will see how you can create a GitHub Pages website. So let's get started. First of all, you need to create a GitHub account. So if you already have a GitHub account, you can skip this step. But I will recommend you to watch the complete video so you can set up your GitHub Pages website properly without any errors. So to get started, just open your favorite browser. In my case, it is Google Chrome. Now go to www.github.com and click on Sign Up. Here you can see that there are three steps to complete GitHub setup. To get started with the first one, simply fill in a username. See that the username is unique and special to you, but also people can identify by seeing it that it's yours. After entering your username, you have to enter your email address. I recommend Gmail for this, but you can use anything. Next, you have to select a strong password with 7 characters, a number, and a lowercase letter. As always, keep your passwords safe. It is always better to use a password manager as it encrypts your passwords. Now click on Create Account button to create your GitHub account. So now you are at step 2. To get started with step 2, simply select a free or a paid plan. The free plan is perfect for most users as it allows you to create unlimited free public repositories. If you want a private repository, please go with the paid plan as it costs $7 per month and 459 rupees in Indian currency. Even if you want to select a paid plan, the sign-up process will change a little bit. In my case, I am selecting a free plan as it is best for hosting a website. After selecting the plan, you can simply click on Continue. Now you are at the last step of creating your account. Now answer the simple questions asked by the GitHub. The first question is, how would you describe your level of programming experience? In my case, I am somewhat experienced, so I am selecting somewhat experienced. Now the second question is, what do you plan to use GitHub for? Here, you're going to select all the purposes you're going to use GitHub for. In my case, they are research, development, and school projects. The third question will be, which is the closest to how you can describe yourself? If you don't have any programming qualification, then you will select I am a hobbyist. If you have a programming qualification, select I am a professional. If you're still learning and not yet certified for programming, select I am a student. After that, fill down your programming interested languages like Android, Java, JavaScript, CSS, HTML, and many more. Finally, click on Submit button, but you can skip this step, although I don't recommend doing that. Voila! You now have your own GitHub account. Now open your mailbox and sign into your email client. In my case, it is Inbox by Google. It is the next version by Gmail. Once you are there, you will get an email saying verify your email address. Open that and click verify. If the link doesn't work, just copy the link and paste it in a new tab. Alright, now your account is verified and you have successfully created GitHub account. It's time to create our first repository. Now, press on the plus button near your profile picture and select new repository. Here, enter your repository name like this. In your case, username.github.io. In my case, it is my username. Enter some description. Now select public or private according to your plan. Now it's always helpful to initialize the repository with a readme file. Initialize this repository with a readme. If you want to add a license to it, click on add license, but it is completely optional. To create a repository, just click on Create Repository button. Now, we have created our first repository. It's time for uploading a website. Now, you can upload a static HTML, CSS, and JavaScript website or a Jekyll site. In this case, to keep it simple, I'm simply uploading a demo HTML page. To upload files, click on Upload Files button and select the files you want to upload. Now, in this page, you can drag the upload files to the selected area or simply click on Choose Your Files and select the files you want to upload. In my case, index.html. Note that the homepage of the website should always be named index.html. If not, your website won't work. Now, after the uploading is complete for all the files, click on Commit Changes to apply the changes to the repository. Now, it might take some time depending on the size of your website. After completion, you will be head back to your repository page. Now click on Settings up top here. Scroll down until you find GitHub Pages. As it says, your site is published at srivatsavasant.github.io. In your case, it is username.github.io. Now click it to open it and see. Yes, I have successfully hosted a website on GitHub using GitHub Pages website. So that's all for this tutorial, and sorry if I've done any mistakes. Please like this video and share this video, of course, with your technical friends, and hopefully subscribe to my channel if you like this. Soon I'll be getting more videos like this. Thank you for watching.